Hello, welcome to the SolidWorks video tutorials. In this video tutorial, we are going to see quick snap option in SolidWorks sketch tools. Now quick snap option is located inside the sketch tools over here, and you can see this option is disabled because we have not entered or into particular command of sketch tools. So when we entered into particular command of sketch tools, this option will be automatically get activated. Now let's start with this tutorial. Suppose I want to draw a line, and this is some random sketch that I have generated, and I want to draw a line that starts from the midpoint of particular line. Then it is very difficult for me to find the midpoint of this line because I don't know the length of this line. So in such cases, what we can do, we can use a quick snap option, and we can select this midpoint snap option. And when we select this midpoint snap option, this SolidWorks shows us the different possible midpoints of lines. If we move our cursor or move our cursor over the particular line, it shows the midpoint of that line. So in this way, we can deselect this midpoint, and we can join the other midpoints, and other midpoints also are visible when we select this midpoint snap option. So in this way, we can join the midpoints of a desired line. So this is the first command inside the quick snap option. I will see other command in quick snap option. Now for the random purpose, I have drawn these points, and now we are going to understand the point snap option. When I want to draw a line and that starts from some point, then we can select this point snap option, and if I move my cursor in particular region, then it shows the point that are possible on in those region. Now I can select any point that I want to choose directly by using this option. Okay, and directly I can join. For joining purpose, again I can select the point snap and I can join the desired points. Okay, so in this way we can use point snap option. Now we'll try to understand the another option inside the sketch tool, that is center point snap. So suppose I want to draw a line that starts from the center of this circle, so I can directly select a center point snap, and directly the center point is now visible. So we can select this point. Again I want to end this line at midpoint of this line, so I can select the midpoint snap option, and I can draw the desired line. Again if you want to repeat the same but different possibilities, that is a center point snap, so again it is showing me the center point, and again I want to end this line at some point snap, that is this point. Okay, so or this point. So in this way I can end this line at particular point. So in this way we can use the point snap, center point snap, midpoint snap. Now we'll try to understand the quadrant snap. Suppose I want to start a line that starts from the quadrants of the circle, then we can select this option. Now we can see the possible quadrants of a circle. When you select this command, you can see this quadrant and this quadrant, this quadrant. So we can start the line from any quadrant that we want to select, and if you want to end this at particular point, suppose again I select a midpoint snap, then we can see the midpoint is already visible, and we can sketch this line. So in this way we can make use of quick snaps for drawing the lines, or in order to simplify the sketch or sketching effort. I will try to understand intersection snap. Now let's try to understand the intersection snap. So in order to understand, we can see over here I have drawn this random line, and there's one line that intersect this basically a curve at this point. And if I want to draw a line that starts from the intersection point, then what I can do, I can select the line command, I can use a quick snap to intersection snap, and if I move my cursor over this point, you can see the intersection is visible over here, and I can just click over here and I can start drawing. But if I again want to end this line at midpoint or any other point, then we can select point snap, midpoint snap, quadrant snap, and center snap depending upon our use. Suppose I select the center snap, and automatically the center point is highlighted. I can end my line. So in this way we can draw a lines using quick snap options. Now there is a snap called as a nearest snap, We'll now try to understand what do you mean by nearest snap. So in order to understand nearest snap is basically used in order to sketch a line that is from the desired point basically. So if I move my cursor over this line, I can see the cross mark that is moving over the entire line, and from the one end to the another end. So I can start my line from any point and I can stop my line on any point. Again, if I select this nearest snap option, then I can stop my line at any point at any inclination. So in this way we can use nearest snap option. Again, we have to see the tangent snap option. For that, suppose I will make a circle that is sketched at the center of the or the origin of the sketch, and again there is one line that I want to sketch. Suppose this is my starting point. Again, if I want to make a tangent snap, that is this line should be tangential, then I can have to select the tangent snap, and then I can see the tangency point at different positions. Okay, so in this way I can draw a tangent snap. Okay, so this line is tangent to this circle at this point, and you can see this relation. So in this way we can make use of quick snap option, that is point snap, center snap, midpoint snap, quadrant snap, intersection snap, nearest snap, in order to avoid the sketching effort and in order to do the quick sketching. So that's all in this video tutorial. In our upcoming video tutorials we are going to see rapid sketch and instant 2D option in SolidWorks 2020. That's all. Thank you.